Hi guys, today we are going to learn about reciprocity theorem. Okay, reciprocity theorem states that in any linear bilateral network, the ratio of response to excitation is constant. Ratio of response to excitation is constant even though the source is interchanged from input terminals to output terminals. Okay, even though we change the source from input side to output side, the ratio of response to excitation is a constant. That is reciprocity theorem. Let us consider a network like this. Let us assume that this is a network, okay, having all the circuit parameters. So which, let us say, a voltage V is connected here. Voltage in the sense, simply it is excitation to the circuit, which will gives a response will be, okay, and according to reciprocity theorem, if we change the place of this excitation to the output side, then the ratios will be constant. That is, see, this network, if you place the excitation at this side, that is, if you apply the voltage at output side, then we'll observe the response like this. According to reciprocity theorem, the ratio of response to excitation, that is I by V ratio, is constant. Okay, that is I1 by V1 is equal to I2 by V2. Now I will explain the reciprocity theorem by a simple network. Okay, so let us consider this network. Okay, so in this network, for this network we are going to apply the reciprocity theorem. So here these two resistors are in parallel with each other, that is 4 ohms is in parallel with 4 ohms and this combination is series with 3 ohms. That is, totally parallel combination results in 2 ohms plus 3, which is equal to 5 ohms. Let us say this is the R equivalent. What is R equivalent? Is equal to 5 ohms. So the total current flowing through the circuit, I is equal to V by R, that is 20 by 5, which is equal to 4 amperes. So 4 amperes is the current flowing. Okay, so at this point the current division will take place. As the values of resistance is same, 2 amperes will flow like this and 2 amperes will flow like this. Okay, so let us say at this point 2 amperes is flowing. Now what we will do is, we will connect the voltage source at this point and we'll observe the response of the network. Okay, so this is the 20 volt voltage source, the same network, we placed the position of voltage source. This is the position of, changed the position of voltage source. Now here this 3 ohms resistor is in parallel with this 4 ohms resistors. 3 ohms and 4 ohms are parallel and that combination is in series with 4. That is the R equivalent for this circuit. So we can write 4 plus 4 3s are 12, that is R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 12 by 7, which is equal to LCM is 7, this is 28 plus 12, 40 by 7. That is R equivalent. R equivalent is 40 by 7. So what is the current flowing through the circuit? I is equal to 20 by 40 by 7. So 20 by 40 by 7 in the sense, which is 7 by 2 amperes. Okay, 7 by 2 amperes. So what we have to do is, we have to find the current at this point. So we have to apply current division rule. So a current across 3 ohms is equal to total current. What is the total current flowing? 7 by 2 amps. That is I R2, opposite resistance, that is 4 by R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2 in the sense 3 plus 4. This is 14 by 7, which is equal to 2 amperes. Is equal to 2 amperes. Here, if you observe in both these two cases, here current is 2 amperes and this is also 2 amperes. Okay. So, this is about reciprocity theorem. Thank you.